Hello, I'm Mr. Arlinger, a retired lecturer in mythology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity, Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. I have a friend named Patrick, and he is very good at the Jewish law, and she is trying to establish that people of Judah tribe were the dominant tribe in Israel, which is true because they had a great knowledge than the other tribes. That is why from Judah became Judaism, Judaism to Jew. And also in their cleverness, they became Jew outwardly. Judah, outwardly they are of Judah tribe. And from Judah tribe, they became Judaism. Judaism is a spiritual self, religious, inwardly, and Jew. So a Jew is one who is inwardly, not outwardly. But when they became outwardly Jew, then they have to renounce their Judah tribe. When they renounce their Judah tribe, they became tribeless. They were born of the legitimate parents, everything. But they have renounced it in favor of Jew. They became Jew outwardly instead of inwardly. When they became Jew outwardly and renounced their Judah tribe, they became bastards, worse than those born of the prostitutes, because they don't know who their father is. But they know it, who their father is, and they renounced him under Judah to Judaism, to Jew. Thus all these Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian, they're all spiritual self. Anybody who become a Christian, Hindu, Muslim, Sikh outwardly, he become a super bastard, fanatic, devils. And that is what Jesus told the Jews in the temple, that your forefathers are super bastard, fanatic devils, John 8 verse 44. But the people, being, you know, soft, they took the word super bastard away from the Bible. They just put devils. And that's why they retorted, we are born of legitimate parents. That is true. They are not born of fornication as earlier a woman was caught in fornication and they brought to Jesus for judgment, mischievous one, you know. And then Jesus told them, you mischievous one, you blame this woman for producing a natural bastard, but you are supernatural bastard. Same way these Mohammedan, if a girl or a woman is caught in adultery, they will stone her to death. But they themselves are Muslim outwardly, super bastard fanatic devils. And nobody points to them that you bloody are super bastards and you are killing a woman caught in adultery. Why? First, take the plank from your own eye and then judge the other. This is blindness we have. So, when Jesus died, apostle died, and the church was, you know, empty, these messianic Jews, who were the rabbis sacked from the temple, they jumped over the wall of the church of God with Torah under their armpit. Torah, the Jewish leaven, is forbidden from the church. And they bring in the Torah and they made people to old customers. Came running, hey, Torah over there, we can enjoy Torah. And they start getting drunk with the old wine of the letters. And when the apostle used to come to deliver new wine, they desireth not the new. The bishop told them, they don't want it. Off you go. And they got one learned man of letters, Oregon. He was honest. Some became eunuchs for the royal kingdom of God. According to that, he cut his genital organ. That is what is written, eunuch. He took the literal sense as Nicodemus took it when he was told, unless he is born again, he cannot know the royal kingdom of God. He said, shall I go back into the womb of my mother? And that is what the Oregon did. Poor Oregon tried to build their covenant of the Jewish people with Abraham. He was stuck. He said, these are Jews, but Abraham was not a Jew. How can I build the covenant? He did not know that a Jew is one who is inwardly, not outwardly. That means people of Judah tribe was so dominant, and they make the people Jew outwardly 100% almost. Very few were left, maybe 1%. So they were the lost sheep with our royal high priest, anointed Christ Jesus, and his messenger, angel John the Baptist, perfect in the moral law. They went into that Judea region, put their camps there to redeem them. It was John the Baptist who called these temple priests who were turning people Jew outwardly. They were catching Gentile, come, become a Jew, and get yourself circumcised. Circumcision is the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac only. Nobody else can have it. So these white Jews you see, they are fake Jews made by those temple priests for the sake of money. When Stephen went there, he warned them, look, our forefather Abraham was a noble man. Don't make fake sons of Abraham. They said they were grinding their teeth. Hey, he's stopping our business, stifling our business. So they told him, take him out and kill him. And they killed him. He warned them. Today, people who are not of the stock of Isaac, they are not of Semitic race, Indian, Iranian. When they enter this fold of Muhammad, they bring in kosher, which they call halal, and this circumcision, which is, they could not bring it into the church of God. They had a great rejection. So they took that one into that fold, and there you are, they have produced fake sons of Abraham through circumcision. Now they are going to kill them, Iran and other thing, they are going to kill them now. So, to whom will you blame? You can't blame a third person. They themselves are to be blamed. Stephen warned them against it, and they killed him. Jesus came to clean their hearts. They killed him. That was the lost sheep Jesus went to redeem out of the 100. Instead of light came among his own of people of Judah tribe, and they loved darkness. They killed our anointed elder brother Christ Jesus, our royal shepherd. So you are approaching the end of the world, and there will be a lot of tribulation starting in 2018 when Israel is 70 years old. Now Israel has full protection of America, Britain, all those people where money and media dominates. The Jewish money and the Jewish media is dominant over there. They are their slaves. And whatever the Jew tell them, they do it. killing of Saddam Hussein was the Jewish wish to kill him. Same of Gaddafi and all those people. They have been killed by the Jewish people. This will be revealed by 2018. There will be a lot of destruction going on in Syria. Saddam Hussein is a duly elected president of Syria. Rebels are not nowhere to be. And Britain, if there's an election in any country, they send representative, go and watch. They are democratically held. They mean they support democracy. In India, they did not hold any election in 1947. They let us fight. We made them to win the war, and that's the reward we got in Mammon. And same, you know, how can Britain support and America support rebels when they support democracy? No way, but they have no conscience. People are sleeping. They have no nation of shopkeeper, Britain. They don't want to offend anyone. And people are not bothered. They are just sleeping, not knowing that atomic war is around the corner in 2023. We are entering into the tribulation period, same period which in Jerusalem happened during 66 AD to 70 AD. Same period we are going to enter into in 2018. Then the commonwealth will know that it's the Jewish people who are doing all this destruction in the Middle East, and they will start to kill them as they did kill in 66 AD Jewish people in the villages, that you dirty people, what wrong Jesus did that you killed him. Same thing is going to happen now in 2018, and they will be killed and they will be running to Israel for protection. And when they are bundled up there nicely, then atomic war will take place in 2023. From 2018 to 23, Israel will have no protection for America, Britain, or any other country, because they would be fully exposed that they are the tares that is mentioned in Matthew 13 verse 24 to 30, that when end of the world come, I will bundle them up and burn them. Now you know, Jesus got rid of the temple priest. Temple priests were the people who were holding law, scripture. They will go open the book, do what is written. That's why Jesus told them, do what they tell you to do, but don't follow their example. But they themselves are floating laws. Hypocrite they were. Even people who were sensible, they came to know, they became atheist, like Matthew and John and other people. And it was those people Jesus picked them up, because they were sensible. They could see what's happening and what is written. They are hypocrite, and they left them. So John the Baptist was the last prophet of the age. The prophet are whip masters for the rabbis. He plied his whip, but again they hated him. They won't let him into the church, into the temple. They hated him. And that's why John the Baptist called them brood of vipers. And these people who died in Germany and other places during Holocaust, it is they, the blind rabbis, are to be blamed. Blind leading the blind into pits of deaths. You can't blame Hitler. Hitler did not kill any. Their own rabbis, who were blind, they led the blind into the pit. They themselves have to be blamed. If they were Jews, inwardly spiritual, and they would not have flouted the laws. Laws were good because they were made in the image of God. In the image of God, you know, God created Adam. Yahweh, it is Yahweh who created Adam. Because Yahweh, the God of nature and of the natural man. Yahweh created Adam, and out of the rib of Adam was created Eve. That means she is subordinate of Adam. She is not independent. And ask these people, you know, who are putting on dog collar, why Yahweh did not create Eve as well. Both of them, they have no knowledge at all. Rabbis would have told them. They were far better than these dog collar hireling priests you have today in churches. They are synagogues of Satan. In Jesus, we have been set free of the rabbis. And these are neo rabbis with the dog collar, worse than those rabbis from the yoke of which Jesus set us free. They were priests, and we are royal priests. Royal priests do not apply law, they are the Lord of the Sabbath. Lord of the Sabbath means that they apply oral Torah. Oral Torah is conscience. So law and prophets were till John the Baptist, Luke 16, verse 16. After that, no law and no prophet and no priest required to proclaim that you have sinned or not sinned. So we go by Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit is our intention, our conscience. When we are doing holy works, then it's holy for the humanity. When we are doing evil one, then it's an evil spirit. Those temple priests were of an evil spirit. They entered into the church of God, found it empty and no one to occupy. Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, and made the situation worse than before the arrival of Jesus. So we are royal priests. Royal priests deal with gospel and not with the scriptures. That's why Jesus said, don't take two shoes, no money in your pocket, and no script. Script means scripture. This Bible is forbidden to be taken with you. Bible is corruption, mixing the Old and the New Testament. Old is old cloth, new is new cloth. And the patch becomes worse, they are more confused than ever before. Ask them, Jesus professed, you know, that if somebody hits you on one cheek, present the other. Then why did he made a whip and beat the traders in the temple? Opposite. What he did was right, but they don't understand why it's right. So this is the darkness we have. So people have to go by their conscience, what is in their heart. It depends upon the society. I lived in Ghana 14 years. Over there, the village chief will do the justice based upon common sense. He will make the people, if there are any boundary dispute or any dispute, you know, they will go to the village chief, take bottle with them, schnapp, and they will all sit down over there, and they give it to the chief. Chief will then open the bottle, and they all drink, you know. At the same time, he will give his judgment. And both go happily, shaking hand with it. How much that justice cost them? He did not open a book, law book. There were no solicitor over there in his court. Just in half an hour or 1 hour, they are happily going, shaking hands. I saw in Ghana, nobody fighting with each other. People not fighting with. They were so loving. If you give them something to eat, they will all share. Here, if they won't share with you. This is society of Mammon, Great Britain, America, all these countries are Mammon dominated. So here I have something written that may throw some more light. I can speak in details, but no customers. Hi, brother Patrick. If you read Luke 16, verse 16, we are no more under law, our sins. So any priest who talk about sins in churches or anyone who talks sins is antichrist. He is bringing those scriptures back and priests back as you see them in the churches. They are synagogues of Satan. But under Holy Spirit and blasphemy, we are under Holy Spirit and blasphemy. The transgression against the Holy Spirit is blasphemy or hypocrisy. Transgression against the moral laws is sin. What is sin in the religious sense is a crime in the secular world. If laws to govern a country are made in the light of Holy Spirit, then they will stand. Otherwise, they are hypocrisies. So I have give you example. You know, I had a house in Wigan, and the water people came and dig outside. There was a lane outside. They dig place to lay new water pipes, because they were old lead pipes. They replaced them with the plastic one. While they were doing their job, they broke my house drainage pipe. And when they broke and the water won't go out, the tenant called the council. They came and repaired it. And the bill was around £1,400. Now, when I came to know that it was the outside which was broken by these water people, I said, why should I pay when it was outside my house and not inside the boundary? So I took the matter to the court, and the judge over there, the man who was judging, he said, no, there's a law that you should maintain the water pipe right outside into the main drain. I said, why should they broke the pipe, the water people, why should I pay? No, you have to pay it. No, does it make any sense? So this is law. Letter killeth, spirit giveth life. So this is the law they have, and I was fined, and I have to pay. Fortunately, my insurance people covered it up. So this is what they is no Holy Spirit. They are dead laws. God is to be worshipped in truth and in spirit. And that is what Jesus told Pilate, that you are sitting on this seat, so far you are righteous and not doing any favor to these Jews, because they are shouting and you are in, they are good sport for you, because they supply you soldiers and other things. You want to keep a good relation with them, as Church of England has a relation with the Queen. Queen is the dominant. Same was the relationship the Pilate, Herod was having with the temple priest. Temple priest was employed by Herod. I'm sure they were taking money, annual money, you know, from the temple priest. The king, you know, was taking annual money because they built the temple. That is how it should be. But most people in these advanced countries are hypocrites. Justice cost a lot of money. know, even you want to seek justice, then you have to hire a solicitor, go to judge. It may take 6 months before it's finished. Lot of money is spent on these courts because of the letters. As I told you, in Africa villages, the chief will do the justice in a couple of hours, which here will take years to do and cost. So who are civilized? Those jungle people are these people with the cars running and all that, materialistic people. Justice costs a lot of money, and money makes the mare go. You have to bribe the judge and you can get the thing done, as the Jewish people are doing in America. Money and media is in the hand of Jews, and they are governing, they are telling the governments over there, go and attack this country, go and destroy that country. And they are happy seeing them being destroyed, as Syria is getting destroyed now. Syria will be destroyed, and then only people will know who is behind these destructions. Libya, Lebanon, every country will be destroyed, and most of them is their own fault too. Because the country belongs to the tribal people, not to Muslim and Christians. Jewish people are governing USA, UK, and other European countries through money and media. The other fold of Mammon, Jesus said, in Jesus we have one fold, which is Church of God, headed by one shepherd, Christ Jesus. Jesus said there's another fold of Mammon, the temple. We have to redeem them. We have to bring them into our fold. But they love the Mammon so much, they don't want to leave that fold. They are going to defeat hypocrites with the law of violence. The common man has the conscience. They have the Holy Spirit. When they come to know what these letters are doing, how the letters is killing, letter killeth, spirit giveth life, then they will bring the spirit in and they will start killing the Jews. And when they start killing the Jews, they will be running to Israel, as they did in 66 AD, from villages to Jerusalem. Same repetition will take place. They are going to defeat hypocrites with the law of violence. Then they will take to looting, and all that will take place, such as killing and looting of the rich, which are mostly Jewish people. Remember, Jesus told a rich Jew that if he needs to be perfect, then he had to return the money back to the poor that he had cheated. Remember Matthew, when he joined Jesus, he was not a cheat. He stood up and said, if I have cheated anybody, I owed money anyone, come forward, I will give him four or seven times. So he boldly said so, that his heart was free of hypocrisy. He loved truth, and his heart was clean like little child. That's why Jesus picked him up. Come. Judas Iscariot was a thief. He used to steal money from the purse, like these dog collar people do in churches. At the end of the month, they put their hand in the purse. Hey, this is my salary. The laborer is worth his wage, as written in the Bible. The wage our Father gives is gospel treasures, not money. So, but who knows gospel? Nobody. They only know the scripture, what is written, and they blindly follow it. At Oxford University, I asked them questions. You know, John the Baptist said, I am baptizing you in water. One coming after me will baptize you in Holy Spirit. Then I asked them, in whose name John the Baptist baptized them? Because he did not baptize the name of God, Father, and Holy Spirit. Then they start thinking, you know, and they have no answer. Then I call them super donkeys carrying holy books. And they are not happy. They say, you call us super donkeys carrying holy books, and then you come to attend our seminars? That's not good. Such would be the nature of justice. Commonwealth will take the law in their own hand, which is common sense. In the ensuing years, and justice would be done before the end of the world in May 2023, when Israel shall be 75 years old. Now 70 years, you know, Israel fully protected, but 5 are concerned with the heart. Remember Luke 16 verse 16? Luke said afterward that from now on there shall be 5 in a house. There are 3 of ego and 2 of mind. 2 against 3, 3 against 2. I put a lot of videos on this subject, and I put this one in Trinity also. All that shown that thing, which, what are those 2 and 3? Yeah. So these are, you know, 5. There are ego and mind. Mind means you do your free will. You can cheat, you can be holy going here, or you could be evil. Evil spirited people. So these are the ego, and then ego of letters, 3. 2 of mind, this greed and worldly temptation. This is ego of your tribal, that I belong to this tribe, that tribe, you know. And then ego of physical prowess, like a good wrestler, footballer, or anything. He doesn't want to listen to anyone. Then ego of letters, as the university professor are, dead in spirit, full of the letters of the Old Testament and New Testament. Old Testament, New Testament mean they end up as super donkeys carrying holy books. The rabbi used to be donkeys carrying holy books because they have the knowledge of New Testament as well, letters. They are super donkeys. Script is not allowed in Jesus to be carried along on your preaching trips. Gospels come from your heart and not from the book. So those who are on book, they are super donkey. They can't give you gospel. As I told you, they don't know in whose name John the Baptist baptized Jewish men or Jesus. Or why Jesus is called Yeshua. What Yeshua stand for, hardly any professor knows it. He's not Savior stand for. He stand for Yah from Yahweh, and Shua mean Adam. He was the firstborn of Yahweh, second Adam. Mary was surrogate mother, and Joseph was foster father. So, I'm expecting riots in May 2018, when the protection of Israel shall be taken away, or the influence of Mammon and media would be gone. People would use common sense, which is the law of the people, not written in the books, but over their hearts, the law of the Gentiles. Let us worship Elohim. You know, this is the time not of Yahweh. In the time of Yahweh, Yahweh was in heaven. He was not with us, alienated from us. This is the temple of Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, created by Yahweh, perfect artist. And He is in Elohim, Allah, Parbrahma, is inside you if you are truthful and clean-hearted person. So let us worship Elohim, Allah, Parbrahma, etc., who is within us if we are truthful and clean-hearted people. This will earn us resurrection as demonstrated by Jesus in Lazarus. Lazarus was a poor man, and he was sitting at the gate of a rich man who had fleeced the poor to become rich. And that's why there was disparity between poor and rich. Such disparity was not among the Gentiles, because they won't fleece others. They were honest. In Jesus, we are royal priests who receive freely. You know, we receive freely. Who receive freely from our Father, royal Father. Royal is one who give. Priest take money from the people, 1/10 of the crop or anything. Royal priests, they give to the church and not take anything out of the church, opposite. Christ Paul was a royal priest. He gave to the church. He did not take anything out of the church. Such is the act called royal. Same one who went to cure somebody in Iraq area, a king and his family about gouts, you know, sickness. And when they were cured and he wanted to part from them, they said, take some gift from us. He said, no. I have given my property to the church, to the poor. Why should I take from you the property of the poor? King doesn't work. He is working on taxes. He is not a royal king. Royal king gives. Kings take taxes. So this queen over here is not royal. She is just a queen and king. They are not royal. It's a psychophancy which makes them royal. Royal. They are not royal. They don't give. They are taking taxes from you. So what type of royalty is this? Who receive freely from our Father, and we give freely. So we are royal priests. Present church is employing hireling dog-collar priests that are worse off than the responsible rabbis. Fulfill Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, the arid spirit, evil spirited, you know, temple priests who were sacked from the temple. They enter into the church of God, and they bring in 7 deacons worse than themselves, and they used to kill people left and right, throwing them before animals and all that. That is why to fulfill, the temple priests were mostly, temple was dominated by the Judah tribe of the Judah tribe people, who became from Judah to Jew, Judaism to Jew. So they were very proud of it, that it's our creation, you know, Jew. So they were dominant in the temple, and they were the one who were occupying the church of God. And they corrupted the thing, making the situation worse than before the arrival of Jesus. That is why Pope was killing left and right. And there is Hazrat Muhammad Sahib had not put a stop to his killing. You don't know what would have happened. That is, a Gentile stood up and gave them a good beating. So take advantage of the light delivered by our anointed royal high priest, Christ Jesus, and earn your salvation by just being truthful and open-hearted people. You remember the story of Ananias and Sapphira? They sold their property and they wanted to enter into the church of God. Peter was the gatekeeper. Peter was told to feed the sheep. So that sheep which one wanted to be fed into the church, Ananias and Sapphira, but they were crook. They sold their property and kept back money. And when Peter asked them, "Is that all you have got? Anything more?" "No, no, that's all." Second time, third time he killed them. And the wife came, same she did, and same they were killed. Both of them was killed for being lying. How many churches you come across in your country where people are truthful, not liar? The priest, dog of the priest, hireling, working for money. He is not working for God. He himself is crook. Why he should not entertain crooks? That's why the priests were doing in temple. That widow's mite was not liked by them. "Hey, what is this small amount? Other people come and give us gold and silver and all this. What is this mite she has brought?" They disliked her. But she gave all she had. So the greed is killing the people. These organized churches are synagogue of Satan, and no wonder Church of England tops the list by glorifying the army soldiers who died killing others in the name of Mammon. And they say they glorified God. What type of God was that? Mammon. So they worship Mammon and they say they glorify God, because they hireling dog holder priest, they worship Mammon too. There was a big question debate on BBC, and in Oxford they had this program, and I went there and I was in the audience 2 years ago or so. And the Nicky Campbell, who is the speaker, who is the organizing that big question, and he had organized one man, David Patterson, who was a retired vicar from Oxford, to be the main speaker on the audience side. So when he started program, he introduced, "Here you are, we have vicar David Patterson to respond to my questions." And he said, "Don't call me vicar. I'm no more vicar. I am retired. I'm not vicar." So he had to stop the program and start again. I was laughing, you know, all the time he had put on dog collar, calling the other people that he's a man of God, but he was working for money, retired. Like any policeman retired, like in a uniform. He is no better than policeman. The other people sitting there, none of them had this noticed this thing. They were all stupid sitting there. So such is the society in which you live. I will come to that one. People living in the jungles are closer to God because they go by spirit and not by the dead letters. Than these mammon-worshipping materialistic nations or countries. You could still worship God living in this country, which is materialistic and nation full of filth. You could still worship God by being honest while living among the crooks. It is like the lotus flower flourishing in dirty and murky waters. Lotus flower is very beautiful and white, but it is in the muddy water, dirty, murky, same as this word, murky. We have to be like lotus flower. My father used to be an inspector of schools. He did BSc in 1920s. We are from village. Being from the village, we were not greedy. We worship God more. So he won't take bribe. He won't give bribe to the officers. He told the teacher to work hard if they want good grade or promotion. The other inspector of schools, they will take bribery, 20-30 rupees every year, and they will put a nice report, he's a good man. The students are not looked after. No good grade, nothing. Students suffered, you know, under them. But they passed, they were rulers, you know, in the village. Like Lord, they were ruling. He's a school teacher, you know, they were respected. They were honoring him that he is our, educating our children. So my father was demoted, and he was very upset, you know, why? I haven't done any, I haven't taken bribe. Why I have been demoted? But God had his own plan. He saved him from being killed while going on his trip. So in the town we stayed, and when this partition of India took place, he saved 2,000 people, came to attack our village. And when he told them, we tribal people going to kill each other, not Sikh and Muslim, they are spiritual self, never born, never die. Not a single Jew died during the Holocaust, because it is spiritual self. How many people know this fact? Ask the university professors, even after explaining to them, they will still say 5 million people died, because it's written. So in Germany, one man, I was standing and asked him, how many Jews died during Holocaust? He said, zero. I said, how the hell do you know this answer? He said, Jew is a spiritual self. Such is the rarity of gospel. Gospel is not common. It's for those who can think, who are capable of intuition. So this is a dirty word. Well, still you can live honest. You can work honest. You don't need to take bribe. You don't need to cheat anyone. You could be, you are still eating and putting on clothes. And this is the time in which people living in their houses can worship God. Whilst in the other ages, when under rabbis, no way. Rabbis will tell them, because we preach gospel which is opposite to the letters. What applies to spirit is opposite to this one, flesh. And he will say, hey, you are confusing my people. So that is why the old time sages or prophets, Daniel and other people, they used to leave the people. They used to go to wilderness, settle there, which is beyond the jurisdiction of the rabbis. And Thomas is a typical example. He went to India, in South India. Now in South India, the Brahmins were not crook. They were honest, because they had shame. Wherever they have conscience, there is the dharma, or faith in God. So when Thomas started preaching there, and people were confused, you know, they complained to the Brahmins, look, he is confusing us, he is telling something different, you know, you tell us different. Because this knowledge of oral Torah, which is his word, was not allowed to the common man. In India, we say that if a person who is not of the tribe doing the profession of Kohen or Brahman, if he hears something in his ears, the mantras or the holy scripture, and he then misinterpret it and tell people something different, catch him and put lead, molten lead in his ears. So this was how the people were frightened. That's why the Jewish people don't write the God even. They put God, they miss this word. Yahweh, they are not allowed to write even the name of Yahweh, Heavenly Father, which is natural, supernatural Father, Elohim, they are not allowed to write. So such is the fear the rabbis had. Hope this video will make the thing clear, that latter killeth and lead you to darkness. In Jesus, we have been forbidden to carry any script with you when you are on preaching tour. Apostles were not allowed to take scripture with them. They wrote it down, their views, for others to read, but they themselves knew what to write, so they don't need something already written because they know it. So that's why, you know, when you see what I have written, I know what is to be written. I'm writing for the general public so they can make something out of it. But I know what it is, so I don't carry scripture with me. I read Bible or other thing to see where they have made the corruption. I get this daily dosage of Bible passages. Then I make corrections in that one, and then I interpret it. Remember Marcion, he rejected the Old Testament altogether. Old Testament is the old cloth, full of holes, which is rotten. You can't patch the old cloth with the brand new cloth, which is New Testament. The patch becomes worse, and that was the confusion you have. Even he tried his best to put the confusion laid by the Messianic Jews into the Bible. In the Old Testament, you have Lord. Yahweh is Lord, because he is lording up in heaven. He is not within you. In Jesus, our Elohim, Parbrahm, or Allah, this is his temple, and he lives inside us. He is no more alienated, but inside us. He is no more Lord over us. He is my Father. And me and my Father are one, as I can sit at his table and we can enjoy storge love. Storge love is the love in which, like family love, when children, wife, everybody sitting at the table, nobody is superior or inferior. So we have equal, you know, status. So with this, I will leave it. It's quite a lengthy video I have made. I hope you will enjoy it. Our Father, not Lord. Lord has slaves, Father has sons. And sons can enter into the house without any hesitation. Slaves are kept outside the door, not allowed on the table even. So that's why those 10 virgins, the first 5 went, knocked at the door, said, Abba, Abba, Father, Father, hey, come in, sons. He welcomed them. And the other sycophants, you know, very clever, they knocked at the door, said, Lord, Lord. He would be very pleased, you know, when we call him Lord. And he said, hey, I'm not Lord. I set people free. I myself is solitary. My sons are solitary. Wife is solitary. Holy Spirit is solitary. I don't make any slaves. Get lost. Find your Lord, Yahweh. And he turned them away. So, if you use your Holy Spirit, get governed by your Holy Spirit. And think logically. When you think logically, you will brew logo. And logo is his word. And it is through his word you talk to our Father, not through prayer and fasting. Prayer and fasting is for the natural man. For the natural man, Yahweh is in heaven. Not for the spiritual man. For the spiritual man, he is inside me. He is no more alienated. He is inside me, called Emmanuel. Emmanuel, our Father God, bless you.